The domestic dog is between the 2 and 3 times a year menstruating. Between the menstruating is an average of 7 months. The estrus cycle is divided in 2 phases. In the first phase, the proestrus, the vulva will swell and the female dog will get a bloody outflow. The ejected pheromones attract male dogs, but the female dog can't be mating in this stage. This stage lasts an average of 9 days to a maximum of 17 days. In the second stage, the swelling of the vulva and the outflow slightly less. The color changes from red to reddish tan, and the female dog now attracts male dogs and other female dogs. The female dogs now accept the male dogs and mating may occur. This phase lasts an average of 9 days. During the second phase, the estrus, the ovulation take place. After a few thirsts occurs, the male's penis is swelling up. This keeps the male dog in the vagina of the female dog. After a few minutes, the dog penis is shrinking and coming loose. Tear off male and female by humans are for both dogs dangerous and painful. In addiction, the dogs are react aggressive to human presence. The first week, the mating take place. 2 cell embryos waiting in the fallopian tubes. The embryos are very resistant to external influences. The second week. At the beginning of the week counts the embryo 4 cells, and at the end of the week the embryo counts 64 cells. It's growing quickly. The embryo is now entering the womb. The third week. On the 19th day, encapsulating the embryos in the womb wall. The fourth week, the development of the eyes and the vertebrae. The head is also prompted. The fetus grows from 5 to 10 millimeters to 14 to 55 millimeters. The developments of the bodies begin and the fetus is most vulnerable. Day 26 and 32 are the best days to make an ultrasound to verify if the mother dog is pregnant. The fifth week, development of the toes and the nails. The fetus now resembles a puppy and the gender is now determined. The eyes that were open are closed now. The fetus is growing from 18 millimeters to 30 millimeters. The development of the organs is nearing his end and the fetus are less susceptible to external influences. You can see now that the dog is pregnant. The sixth week, development of the skin and the pigmentation. The nipples of the mother dog will become more developed. The fetus now weighed about 6 grams and is 45 millimeters big. Heart sounds can now be heard with a stethoscope. The seventh week. The growth and development continue. The hair around the nipples of the mother dog starts to fall out so the puppies can better drink when they are born. From day 49, you can clean the nipples and vulva gently with warm water. You can also cut some hair around the nipples if necessary. The 8th week. During the sleeping breaks from the mother, you can feel the puppies move. From day 57, the pups can easily come into the world. The 9th week. Growth and development continue until birth.
What you see here is a mother dog in labor. She just gave birth to the first 3 puppies and the next one is on its way. 24 hours before the birth starts, the body temperature of the female dog drops about 1 degree. Just before the actual labor, the female dog gets contractions and she becomes restless. When the first puppy is on its way, the mother lays down and starts to push. When the pup is born, the mother dog removes the membrane and starts to lick her young. She does that to stimulate the breathing process. She also bites through the umbilical cord and eats the placenta. At last, it is important that the dog can labor in a quiet, clean and private space like this whelping box. This dog gave birth to 5 puppies. This is a normal sized litter for a border collie. The average lies between 4 and 9 pups at a time. Here you see pictures of the parents of the puppies you are about to see. On the left you see the mother, she is a blue merle border collie. On the right you see the father, he has a black and white coat. When the puppies are 3 weeks old, the real adventure begins. The puppies can walk better now and they want to explore the world around them. From this age, the socialization begins, and the puppies must get used to new people, other animals, objects, sounds and smells. These 3-week-old puppies can see and hear now and are able to play with each other. The playing is not only for fun, but the puppies also establish the pecking order in the group. It is important to know that puppies can't regulate their body temperature very well, so it's very important to keep them warm by using a heat lamp, for example. It's time for dinner, but before the puppies get their milk, the mother dog licks her children to stimulate excretion. After this, she lies down on a good spot, so the puppies can get the milk from her nipples. Sometimes the feeding process is a little rough, when the puppies struggle for the best spot. In the first weeks, this feeding ritual takes place 4 to 6 times a day. After approximately a month, the puppies get their first solid food mixed with water. After 6 weeks, the puppies are able to chew and swallow solid food. After the feeding, the offspring often goes to sleep. In the first weeks of their lives, the puppies sleep 90% of the time, so they need a lot of rest.
When a puppy grows up, he learns things like eating with other animals. But it's also fun to learn tricks. They must be able to hear notes, which they can be recalled. Border collies are often used for sheep herding. This is because they are very small. The dog assists the herdsman of driving the mother sheep for the control of the lambs. When you buy a puppy, let him outside for your home quietly walk on the bench. Then, go for a walk in the neighborhood. Please remember that a puppy is still small and cannot walk long. This is also a bit on the size of the breed. At home, you should make sure that there is nothing on the ground where they can chew in. Move you to the eye level of your puppy and see what you find. Remove it from the ground so can be a puppy swallowing and choking. What you need to buy a puppy? First, a bench. Put a bench in a quiet place so that they can return. Second, a feeder. Get two solid feeders where you chunks and water in those because they can sometimes play. As third, the brushes. This is necessary for the dog with long hair, so the hair stays net. They do not come into the kennel. Fourth, the toys. A puppy would still play a lot and have sharp teeth, so get good toys where they well can chew in, otherwise they bite the chairs in the room to pieces. And finally a belt, which you go walking. Make sure that the belt is the weight of the dog can wear when the dog is mature. So you only need one time to buy a belt. Next.
Your eyes, they tie me down so hard, I'll never learn to put up a guard.